Sounds fascinating.
Time does not permit me to do this.
Wonderful.
Zoe on the LoveLine phone.
Hello?
Hello.
Hi. I have a question. I'm seeing a guy now, wonderful guy, but to put it politely, let's just say he's slightly petite or more petite than I'm used to.
Uh-huh. He's got a waif penis.
Okay.
That guy out the bar.
Okay, I'll go with that for now. About a couple months ago, he introduced a vibrator into our little playtime adventures, and now I'm just totally afraid I'm becoming addicted, and pretty soon I'm just going to think, like, what are you doing here when I have this vibrator? And it's just really getting... And you can't tell him, you know, it's a very sensitive issue with men. You can't just say, okay, you're too small.
Right.
This is more fun than you. It just... So I'm wondering, you know, if there's a way we can incorporate in it that it's not becoming the focus, because...
Zoe, we understand your question. We're all going to think about it. We're going to watch Drop Dead Gorgeous, the new Republica video, and we'll be back after this break. You have questions. Good. Drew, how do they find us?
They can find us at 213-520-LOVE. That again, 213-520-LOVE. Go ahead and call us with your questions and participate.
We are back with Republica. And when we left off, we're speaking to Zoe. Now, Zoe's problem is the following. Zoe's boyfriend is not real well endowed. He made the mistake of bringing in something that was bigger than he, which I personally never do. I don't care even if it's furniture in the bedroom. It does not enter the bedroom if it's bigger than me.
Schoolboy era.
Which means there's nothing in there, actually. I did sneak in some chapstick the other weekend. But the point is I will not do this. He brought it in, and now she likes a vibrator more than he, right, Zoe?
Yes, sort of. Basically, yes.
Uh-huh. And you want to know how to tell him, or?
Well, I guess it's just, you know, as opposed to being, like, either, you know, it's almost like it's an either-or with him. It's like, okay, we're having sex, or tonight we'll play with the vibrator, instead of, like, using both, which seems it wouldn't make it into this big of an issue for me.
If he would use both.
If he would just think of it more, I don't know.
Creative.
One question, do you love the guy? I mean, is the relationship solid, and do you want to stay with him?
He's a very, very wonderful guy, and it's just the actual penetration part of the sex, which is not satisfying. I mean, other things that he does are great, but that particular part is...
Well, hold on, Zoe. Saffron asked you a specific question.
Yeah?
Do you love him, though? Are you in love with him?
Well, I don't...
You're not, are you?
No.
No, okay.
No. I care about him, but I wouldn't say that.
Are you thinking about eloping with the vibrator?
Wait, what did you guys say?
It's very low maintenance, I must say.
Did you guys say get rid of him? You said get rid of him? Is that...
No, well, I can't do it just for that reason, it seems.
Well, but it's just a symptom, Zoe.
Right.
That's Saffron.
Well, that's true.
Go ahead, Saffron. You were advising her.
Well, it's just me personally, but I think, you know... I think you should be in love with somebody that you're in a relationship with, and if you're not, and especially on a sexual level,
right,
he's not satisfying you. You either work that out with him on a friendship level, or, you know, you shouldn't be in a relationship.
Is it something... is it something you can't discuss
right
with him?
She's absolutely right.
Yeah.
And you wouldn't be having this problem, or you'd be working it out if it were somebody you really cared about.
Yeah.
Well, it's true.
Yeah.
It's also when you start finding, you know, specific things like this wrong, it's usually a symptom of something else.
That's right.
Yes.
Very good.
Oh, okay. You have a lot of
That's
insight.
That's what I was afraid of.
Yeah.
All right, Zoe.
Sorry,
okay.
Sorry.
Hey, do they have a cool English name for vibrators?
That or dildos, I think, are the only ones that really use.
but that's ours. We started
yeah,
that
Yeah, you
one.
Started that one.
Hey,
yeah,
guys, we just got an email. An email for a Saffron. They put it through here. It says, is Saffron still hooked up with her boyfriend? It's from Grady M333.
Yes.
Yes.
And are you in love with him?
Yes, I am.
All right, I'm going to have him killed.
All right, this is Michael on line two. Michael?
Yes.
He's 24. Go ahead. What's your question?
Well, my girlfriend and I have a very healthy relationship sexually, and a lot of times I'll pull out and like climax on her belly or wherever it happens to fall. And the other day, I kind of shot too far, I guess, and it hit her in her eye. And it's not to brag or anything, but I guess it went a little too far. And it actually hit her in her eyeball, and
that's very dangerous.
She's starting to, I guess, have an irritation in her eye. Her eyes turning red, but she's also a swimmer, so I don't know if it's like because she swims or because.
All right.
I don't know.
Look.
It's down to jism.
It is irritating to the eye, and what she's developing is something called a conjunctivitis, which is an inflammation of the lining of the eye. My concern is that things like chlamydia and gonorrhea can cause a serious eye infection. Herpes can cause a serious eye infection. And just on the chance that this could be happening, because these are quite serious, she ought to see an ophthalmologist or at least a doctor right away just to get checked out. It can be treated usually pretty easily.
She ought to keep the swim goggles on and... I'm working on a device based loosely on the mud flap principle that big rigs use that's going to come out soon to just solve these problems. All right, well, it'll even have the little chromed silhouette of the naked woman on it. This is the Republica CD. Thank you, Republica, for coming out tonight. If you haven't already got it, go out and get it. And if you already got it, get another one. You know what I'm saying. Thanks, Chris McGaha.
Thanks, guys. From McGaha, here's Pete Agnew.
And until next time, this is Adam Carolla for Dr. Drew. Say mahalo.
LoveLine is a Stone Stanley production.
Yeah. Cool.